What's up guys? Click the subscribe button and press the bell icon to stay updated with our videos. Hello students and welcome back to bankexamstudy.com. So yesterday was NABARD grade A, you know, exam. Right now we are doing an analysis. We are working on Sunday and tomorrow I'll come back with a proper analysis of NABARD grade A exam. But from today onwards, we are going to start a series in which I am going to discuss important 5 questions from a particular topic, from an important topic. So today's topic is Uday Kotak Committee on Corporate Governance. This is a very, very important topic for upcoming RBI Grade B exam and also for the mains paper of NABARD Grade A and also for the Bank of India Credit Officer exam. So let's start. What are the 5 important questions from this committee, from Uday Kotak Committee on Corporate Governance? The recommendations of this committee has been accepted. This was in news from last, I think, 6-7 months. This is a very hot topic. So the most important question, so question number 1 is the gender diversity. Now there is a rule that one independent director should be there in top 500 listed companies from April 1st, 2019. In the board of directors, there should be one woman independent director in the top 500 committees from April 1st, 2019, and in top 1000 listed companies from April 1, 2020. So this can be the question. About a date, from which date there should be there is a compulsion of one woman independent directors in top 500 companies, or there can be a question, according to Uday Kotak Committee, there should be at least one woman independent director from which date in the top 500, top 1000 committees, top 1000 companies, from which date this rule is going to be implemented. It's 1st of April 2020. Right. So very important, gender diversity in the top 500 and top 1000 listed companies from April 1st, 2019 and April 1st, 2020 respectively. Very important question, student. Sure, you should remember this. Don't worry. Don't take the notes. I'm going to provide the notes in the description. Don't worry. And the second one, maximum number of directorships. Now, according to Uday Kotak Committee's recommendation, this recommendation is actually accepted. One person can be, director of 8 listed companies. One person, one individual can be director of 8 listed entities. And in case of individuals, he cannot be, director of more than 7 companies in case of an independent directors by 1st April 2019. And from 1st April 2020, this number is 7 listed entities. One person cannot be a director of more than 7 listed companies from 1st April 2020. So maximum number of directorships. Second question. Third question is very important. It is about board interlocks. What is a board interlock? Simple. There is a person A, or let's say there is person, let's say Rahul. Mr. Rahul is a person, right? He is the executive director of company ABC, right? And he is the independent director of company QRS. I'm going to discuss the independent directors in my next video. Actually, this independent director video is actually available in my course, RBI Grade B 2018 course. I request all of you to take that course, download the notes, watch the video classes and take the full length test. So let's get back to the board interlocks. So A is, let's say, is the executive director of XYZ and he is the independent director of QRS. Now, there is person B. He is the executive director of company QRS. He cannot be an independent director of company XYZ. Because A, who's Rahul actually, there will be a board interlocks. There is person A who is executive director of company ABXYZ and who is independent director of company QRS. Now there is person B who is executive director of company QRS. He cannot be an independent director of XYZ. There cannot be board interlocks. There cannot be board interlock. This is known as the board interlocks. I'll provide a simple image which will explain the simple board interlock that is banned now. The board interlocks are banned now. Very important concept. That was question number 3 from Uday Kotak committee. Now the fourth one, what is a material subsidiary? What is the definition of a material subsidiary? There are additional disclosure requirements for the material subsidiaries, but what is the definition of material subsidiary? A subsidiary in whose net worth or income exceeds 10% of net worth of or income of holding company is known as a material subsidiary. So more than 10%, it is a material subsidiary. This limit was revised from 20%. It used to be 20%, but now it is 10%. What is a material subsidiary? If net worth of or net income is more than 10% of net worth or income of holding company, this is known as a material subsidiary. Very important. Fifth important question from Uday Kotak committee. It is the top 100 companies, they need to do top 100 listed companies, they need to do webcast of their annual AGM, of their annual general meeting. The top 100 listed companies, listed entities, they need to do the webcast of their AGM. This is compulsory for the financial year 2018-2019. Very important question. So student, these are the 5 important questions from Uday Kotak committee. I'm going to provide proper notes and I have actually done a proper class in our course. So I request all of you to take a demo course of RBI Grade B 2018. The demo course is available on bankexamstoday.com. You can create an account there or you can just install Bank Exams Today mobile application and you can also take a demo course there. So if you like the demo course, you can join the complete course. You'll be getting the complete video classes, complete notes and the complete test series. In case you have any other doubt, you can call me back. My number is 906720100. And tomorrow, I'll be back with the proper and in-depth analysis of NABARD Grade A exam. I mean, right now we are matching which questions came from our study material. So at the end of the day, we need to measure our performance, right? So tomorrow I'll be back with the deep and in-depth analysis of NABARD Grade A exam. Why we didn't make a proper lecture or a video yesterday? Because we are not in a hurry, right? Because see, everybody's just mentioning these many questions from data interpretation, these many questions from, you know, from this QT, from simplification, and we are not into this thing. I mean, doing such analysis is not our job. So what we are going to do is we are going to do an in-depth analysis. We are going to, you know, compare the exam with our study material. So we will prepare a complete memory based paper. That is obviously we are going to share that. And tomorrow I'm going to make a proper lecture on how to prepare for the mains exam. If you have attempted, according to you, if you hope you'll be scoring more than 110, if you have attempted more than 120 questions in general category, then you should start your preparation for the mains exam. So student, that's all from me. That's all for today. Tomorrow I'll be back with another lecture on NABARD Grade A analysis. That's all for today, students. I request all of you to subscribe this channel and I request all of you to press the bell icon. There was a giveaway for RBI Grade B annual subscription. I'll be back with more. I'll be more frequent with such kind of giveaways. But for today, just subscribe the channel and press the bell icon. And if possible, just take a demo course. That is actually very important for me. So that's all for today, students. Thank you and have a very nice day. Bye.